A ninth round of talks between US and Taliban representatives has ended in Doha without a substantial agreement. But the US side say they are, quote, at the threshold of an agreement that could see the US pull out from the country. The final details are still unclear. But what is clear is that the Taliban aren't hanging around waiting for a deal. Over the weekend, they attacked the cities of Kunduz and Puli-Khumri in the north of the country. Now, Kunduz has already been attacked twice before in the last 4 years. So what is the Taliban game plan? DW correspondents Masood Saifullah and Shamil Shams put that to Taliban spokesman Suhail Shaheen in Doha.
We are talking here about the end of occupation. That's why we are the negotiation are continuing, they are underway, and we also want to address the concern of the US not to use, not to allow anyone to use the soil of Afghanistan. So that's the main thing of the both sides. We are focusing on those things to resolve them. So when these are resolved, I think there will be no room for other statements in concern.
Well, joining us for more is DW correspondent Sandra Petersman, who's been following the many rounds of talks in Doha. Sandra, welcome. Now, while the Americans were talking to the Taliban in Doha, you had the Taliban attacking two cities over the weekend in Afghanistan. Is the Taliban essentially controlling the narrative in Doha from Afghanistan?
I think they're trying to very much, but what you must keep in mind, Biresh, is Afghanistan was the world's deadliest conflict in 2018, and chances are that it will remain the world's deadliest conflict in 2019 too, because despite the peace talks or framework agreement talks in Doha, the fighting hasn't stopped. Afghanistan is still essentially a country at war. And yes, we have seen the Taliban attacking Kunduz and Puli-Khumri over the weekend. Fighting is still ongoing in other parts of the country too. There is no clear front line, so civilians get caught in the crossfire time and again, with Taliban attacking villages and cities, but also, you know, air raids by US forces and Afghan forces at the same time. So it's really a country at war, essentially.
But it's also, you have a situation in which you have two parallel tracks. You have talks going on in Doha, and then you have this violence on the ground. Clearly, both sides have a lack of trust when it comes to each other. In this environment, whatever deal is agreed in Doha, whenever it's agreed, what are the chances the elements of it will be implemented?
I think that's two separate things, essentially, because what we have seen at the moment is talks between the Taliban and the United States about, on the one hand, troop withdrawal, that is the main Taliban demand, and on the other hand, a break with Al-Qaeda and other elements of terror in Afghanistan, that is the main US demand, so that they can pull out troops in phases. Whatever comes after, comprehensive ceasefire, intra-Afghan dialogue, the other two elements, those still have to start. Those still have to be implemented. And if everybody will be on board, whether there will be disgruntled members of the Taliban, then maybe joining, you know, the Afghan version of Islamic State, that remains to be seen. It doesn't mean that in the case of a framework agreement between the US and the Taliban that we will see Afghan peace blossom, you know, the very next day.
Right. So essentially what you're saying is that the framework agreement that is under discussion in Doha is essentially something that serves more the US interest and the Taliban interest than the Afghan?
I would say yes, because the Americans, especially President Trump, have a very keen interest on pulling troops out. You know, he's also campaigning, he wants re-election, and if he manages to pull troops out, of course, that will be very well received in the United States. Whether this is a good or a bad thing for the people of Afghanistan is an entirely different story, because what we need to see is really intra-Afghan dialogue. We need to see the Afghan government and the political elite, opposition forces, sit down with the Taliban, because that is where a peace deal lies.
Sandra, do you think, very briefly, that the Afghan government, if it does get involved in the talks at some point, there could be some agreement down the line with the Taliban?
Well, obviously, the draft agreement, which is on the table, we don't know the details, was shown to the Afghan president in the meantime, and he is now considering how to proceed. I think in the end it would be, for the sake of the Afghan people, a good move if he would agree and if the Taliban would agree to intra-Afghan dialogue, because that's what is needed to bring peace to Afghanistan.
Sandra Petersman, thanks very much for that. I'm sure we'll be speaking soon about these talks.